two, one, two, three, four. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the channel. John Fix and I are certainly glad to see you today. We're pretty excited because some time ago we restored a Rawlplug mechanical hammer drill from the 1950s, a very rare item that we had to bring over from England. Well, we found out since then there was an earlier model made around 1930. So we went in on a search for it, and a good friend from the Netherlands helped us find it and shipped it to us. We'll tell you more about him later. In the meantime, we're pretty excited about this new addition, this rare tool. Let's get down to the shop and check on the restoration.
Some time ago, shortly ago, right before Christmas, Scout Crafter said you should get yourself something special for Christmas. Well, I did, and it arrived just right after Christmas and right before my birthday, so this is my special present. What it is, I had a Rawlplug mechanical hammer drill, rotary hammer, that I showed you recently. I did an updated video on it that was made in the UK by the Rawlplug Corporation there. I got one, I got it shipped to me, and I restored it. Just loved it. Really just one of my best items of all time. I looked for years for one of those. Well, Alex, a listener from the Netherlands, or a watcher who watches YouTube and has also done a lot of work procuring items for Ben, the tool addict, told me that he sees these occasionally. He's from the Netherlands. He sees them advertised on eBay and around, and he said he thought he may be able to find me one. This is an earlier model that was done almost 100 years ago. It was made in Belgium, and he found it for me. Bought it, had it shipped to him, packaged it, shipped it to me. What a super nice thing to do. Alex, I can't appreciate you enough. I haven't opened it yet. I'm just going to open it now and have an unboxing for everybody. It may be a little bit involved because it's well packed. Let me get to work on it here. Okay, I'm going to pause for a minute, get a little bit more of this wrapping off. He did a super job of packing this. Okay, got it open this far. Looks like something inside. Well, he packaged this very well, very well. It's a great job because it had a long way to come and through the international travel. Look at that triple, quadruple layer inside of cardboard. He really built it like a safe. It was great. Now we're starting to see what's so special about this. A wooden handle on a tool. You just don't see that. And he was careful to get me a wooden handle that was intact because that was one of the key parts. There are some out there for sale that had broken handles on them and had been modified and or repaired. This is stock original. Don't know what kind of wood it is, but I'm sure that will refinish well. This metal housing on it, an unusual, like diamond plate steel. told me at the time that not all the screws seem to be original, but I'll be able to get those original. We're going to strip this one down completely and get it working. Here's the other items with it. Oh, well, there's an additional item, which is very nice. It's a handheld raw drill. This one, you hold it. It's got a star drill on the end. Wasn't expecting this. And there's the little drill bit. And you hold this against the concrete and hit it with a hammer and turn it with your hand to drill a hole. And look, it's got the original Rawlplug label on it. Dynamite item. So there's a bonus. Wasn't expecting that. And of course, this drill bit will fit in here to drill with this tool. I'm sure this is the handle. The original handle, all intact. The wood is in, needs refinishing, but is in really good shape. Not cracked or broken. This is one of these where a handle fits on either side, installs on either side, and works the same way by reversing it. The handle installs. That's another step. So you can see the Rawlplug name. Rawlplug mechanical hammer. Belgian made. It's got the British patent number. So this was around 100 years old. Same thing on the other side. So we're going to take this one all the way down. Completely restore it. Going to be a wonderful addition to my collection. Means a lot more to me because I worked for the Rawlplug company here for many years. But that is an offshoot from the Rawlplug England company. So Alex, just tremendous, got me my tool along with a bonus item. I am so happy to get this. I can't tell you how pleased I am. And thank you for all the extra efforts to buy this, to get it, to pack it, to ship it to me. That's really going out of the way to do a nice thing for somebody. And if I can ever return the favor, I will. But in the meantime, just thanks again. I'll be back to show you the restoration and show you the finished product. Okay, we've torn the tool down to the bare bones and done a lot of cleaning. There was a ton of old dried caked grease in here, 100-year-old grease. And we got a lot of that cleaned up inside here. The parts themselves have still got it on them. The outer covering here of the housing, you can see how dirty and caked it was. We got this cleaned up. That's in interior, but I want it cleaned inside and out. And the exterior looked like this. And basically, I just went over it with a steel wool to try to knock it down a little to see, how well it's going to clean up. And we'll have to work some magic on this, but that's a real key component of how the tool looks. I've also got a patent number on here, and I'm going to look up the patent on this tool. Which will be nice. Everything seems to be, all the parts are here except for the screws that held this outer housing on. We've only got two of them and only one of the little nuts. And it needs to recess down in here and to recess. It had a certain shape on it. And the shape kind of like a flat or oval on this side, and then really strange shape to fit down in here to receive this, because the other ones were put on. Well, this one screw was the wrong size completely. And then there was a hex nut on one and a square nut on the other rather than this. And we want to, so we'll find out the threads. I'm sure this is probably metric. And get some, you know, replacement screws for the two that are missing, and we'll have to get probably a hex nut and machine it where it'll shape like this when it's finished. It'll be a little bit of a tricky maneuver, but we'll see what we can do. But that way, when the tool's closed up, this finish, you know, the bolt comes through and it finishes looking nice on the side, rather than a big hex nut or square nut on there like it was on there as a replacement. Interior wise, just a lot of cleaning. Nothing's broken except for one thing, and that is, other than the various nuts and bolts we need to find to assemble this tool, this is the one part we have to deal with. It's going to be difficult. This is the part that rotates, and it opens up the hammer mechanism and then releases it to hammer against the bit that's held here and make it turn or make it hammer. Also, this is the post for the turning handle. And on the left side, it screws in. On the right side, it's broken off. So the handle could only work on the left side because this is completely sheared off. You can see it there. This post screw, I'll call it, it fits on the turning mechanism for the hammer. You can see how it's damaged. So, and this one is just semi-stripped, worn down and kind of stripped. So this is going to be difficult. I've got to, I don't know, have a part made, come up with a, because this is two different configurations or two bigger, you know, sizes of screw threads. So I'm assuming this will come apart. I don't know at this point. We have to get a machine shop to make a part. It's going to be a little bit difficult. So that'll be the hardest thing to deal with, other than the cleaning and straightening and finding of the other parts. So I'll get to work on it. Okay, let's check on our progress. Got quite a bit done recently. Got these sides polished. The insides cleaned. Took the handle and polished the dark metal to a shiny finish. Still got to refinish the handle. On a mission tomorrow to try to find some, I determined these are 4mm bolts. So I'm going to have to see what I can find that I can work on and make it fit the profile of what I need. And here's where the tool stands. It's assembled, oiled, works, ready to go. Haven't actually done any drilling with it yet, but the components inside. You can see the outside here, we shine the metal. And the handle's been sanded. And to get it ready for staining, it's gonna be a beautiful piece of wood on here when that's finished. So that's where we are now. We'll continue on. To finish up this tool, I mentioned that the bolts and nuts on here had been modified somewhat. People just using parts, whatever needed over the years. On one of them was this, instead of a flathead, it was a roundhead bolt. I did determine they were 4mm, so that helped. And of course, on the back side, instead of a countersunk part, it had a hex nut. And the other one had a square nut. And the other one had a hex nut on it. So I needed to make some parts to complete this. I had only one of the units, which was this. It was a oval head, just slightly oval head, but oval head slotted 4mm bolt. And I tell you, that just was not to be found anywhere. I knew I'd have to do some modifications. And on the back side, the part that countersunk in the tool with just a little, you know, countersunk type piece. You can see it here. And so I needed to find something similar to work. And what I did was I found some four millimeter bolts. But if you look and see there, Phillips head, 4mm Phillips head, that's all I could find. And I was trying to modify some hex nuts, but hex nuts were just a little too small and too slim to put that bevel on there. I needed to countersink it, so I made these parts, if you can see, and this, I'll assemble it here. Maybe I'll see it a little better. I took a hex nut and actually a hex lock nut, because it was a little longer, so I could put this bevel on here, and I put this bevel on it so it would countersink down in these areas here. So I made three of these. They got two of these that were actually longer than what I needed in a 4mm Phillips. Anyway, ended up making the necessary parts to get this reassembled so it wouldn't look so clunky with the round head wrong length bolt and a square nut on it. Okay, here's the fun part. Remember the ugly, cruddy tool? It wasn't working. Really dirty, grungy. Made in about 1930, so about 90 years old. Needed some love. My friend Alex in the Netherlands found it for me, bought it, shipped it to me. Took a great effort to do all that, and I thank him again. I just am treasuring this piece. Anyway, it's done. I'm ready to show you the results. And here's a little comparison for you of the two tools. If I can get this to look right. You can see how it improved. Just amazing. The wood was restored. There are some lines and so forth in here, just part of the character of the wood, but it was stripped, sanded, and completely restored. You can see it all the way around. Put a nice finish on it. Vast improvement. All the metal, it was dark and black, was shined all the way around. The turning handle, which was a black finish, I sanded down and got a bright, shiny finish on it. And of course, the side plates on both sides. The diamond plate looking side plate with the name, you can see very well now. Rawlplug mechanical hammer. It's got the patent number, which I have been unable to find the patent. And Belgian made. This was the Rawlplug company in England, but they had this tool made in Belgium, and it was done in the 1930s. Again, a huge improvement over holding a drill in a holder in your hand and banging on it with a hammer. Turn the crank and drill a hole. Now, here's how the screws ended up. See, those were the two slotted original screws. And on this side, I've got two Phillips because I just couldn't find any slotted flathead 4mm bolts. But on the back side, the little, this was the original, and those were the three other ones that I made into a countersink piece for the bolt to made into. So, finished out nicely. The tool is just a dynamite looking little tool. I really wanted it because of the wood handle, and because you just doesn't see tools made like this with wood handles on them. So I was very, very pleased with it. For comparison, here is the 1950s version that Rawlplug had this tool made in England and updated it, put in aluminum housing, worked very similarly. I've drilled with both of them and don't see a lot of difference as far as performance in them. They both perform very well and do what they're supposed to do. This was just updated because of the materials used in it, putting it in an aluminum housing and make them, you know, a little more durable tool. But again, this one's about 7 years old. This one's 90 years old. And by the way, I will say one thing on this tool I couldn't repair, and that is the tool works from either side, but on the right-hand side, this strange-looking bolt that's through here that holds the turning mechanism that operates the hammer motion is sheared off. I don't know how to get another one unless I actually have one custom made in a machine shop. So I did find a way to get this working on the left-hand side. So this is a left-hand operating drill instead of both sides. And I'm ambidextrous, so it works for me. I don't know why, you know, it couldn't work for other people, but it's the only way I could make it work. Right now might be a good time to drill a hole. Let's check it out. Okay, let's drill a hole in a piece of concrete here. Yeah, you can see the distance. About 3/4 of an inch into the concrete. Little drill works great. Here's the two Rawlplug mechanical hammer drills from 1950 and 1930 displayed side by side. I am so happy to get these, restore them, and display them here. I built this special display. Unfortunately, I just don't have any room for it, so I'll probably end up just putting them on the wall with the other drills. In the meantime, I hope you enjoyed the video. I thoroughly enjoyed it. Just part of my history, so it makes it just great for me. Thanks for watching my video.